cam break in. Your 188 220 cam. First time I'm doing this, but I researched a good bit. I didn't look at just Cummins break in. I looked at all types of flat top and cam break ins, trying to get the best of everything, as much information as possible. What I can found is one thing you don't want to do is let it idle, like not at all. So as soon as it starts up, make sure you have oil pressure before you start it. For me, I pulled the shut off lever to keep the fuel from shooting the injectors open. And then once I did that long enough, I knew there was oil pressure, then I opened it up, let it fire the engine up. As soon as the engine fired, I went right to 2000 RPM. I was running about 100 PSI oil pressure. The engine's warmish now, finally. Oil pressure starting to go down as the heat comes up. Basically what I think you want to do is go from about 1500 to 2500, stay within that window. I've gone up to almost 3 grand just a couple times, just like this. Want to make sure it's always varied. You don't want it just cold at 1 RPM. Cooling temperature is finally getting up here pretty fast. Once it hits, I guess, the 180 mark, I'm gonna shut it off, drain the oil. I'm gonna put the 20W50 in there with my 1540. Filter, drive that for a few weeks, and then I'll change it again. You got to adjust the valve as well. I'll tell you one thing, this 188 220 is loud. The exhaust is much louder. It's really responsive. At 1500 and 25 for most of it. Ideally, you have someone there watching outside just in case anything leaks. I stuck my head under the truck when I was doing this. Didn't see anything. Keep an eye on oil pressure, fuel pressure. So far, I am in to doing this 13 minutes. Another minute and then I'm going to shut it off. I'm not even going to let it idle, I'm just going to shut it off from high RPM. Keep lots of oil pressure on that as it shuts down. See that? So you still have lots of oil pressures that cam slows down, stops rotating. Instead of coming down to idle where it's only 20 PSI, this way it's shutting off at 60 PSI oil pressure. This, I think, is the ideal way to do this. Everything's up temperature. I'll be back with a little road test here once I change the oil.